Hi everybody, my name is Gaming Mule and welcome to Gaming with Mule Live on Daydreamer Gaming. Today we are back with another Elite Dangerous video. And this is an important one, I have to say. This is something I've never done before in Elite Dangerous. And it is a huge undertaking. And I started doing this yesterday, but it occurred to me at the end of yesterday that I need to document this. And the best way to do it, I feel, is through a stream. Now, what I'm doing is I am heading to Jack Station in the Colonia system. Now, this is the furthest I have ever travelled. There is a community goal on at the minute, which is the same as one that's been on previously, where different kind of community factions can get a base over in Colonia. I'm not interested in any of that, but I really want to travel there because it's such a huge distance. It's going to do wonders for my exploration rank, and it's kind of for bragging rights as well. That's basically one of the main reasons why I want to do it, to say that I have been to Jack Station. So I'm here, as you can see, in my Asp Explorer, the Muladong Explorer. I'm using the new camera feature that was introduced in the latest update, the Commander's 2.3 update, and it looks great. I love using this camera. It looks so cool, you've been able to use it. And I've just done a bit of a boost there. I didn't even mean to do that. Right, let's come out of that. So here we are in the Asp Explorer. As I say, I did start this venture yesterday. I was just playing this game just off stream, and it eventually occurred to me how important this was. Now, to put this into context, I'm going to open the galaxy map and I'm going to show you what we are doing. So this is where I am at the minute. I'm at the Smoju ZXU C29 system. So if I just kind of zoom out a bit, you will see how far I have travelled so far from the bubble. Now, this took me pretty much all day yesterday. Now, those of you unfamiliar, this is the bubble. And this is kind of like the main system where everything is going on. Sorry, not the main system, the main area. So you can see I've got some bookmarks there where there's some engineers. I've got a few ships stored around in a few of these areas. This is where most people hang out, this system around here. And I've traveled all around this system, and, you know, it's pretty much a doddle. It's fine. It can take a little while to traverse around this place, but overall, it's fine. And, like I say, to put this in perspective, this is where most people hang out, just this area. Now, if I zoom out and zoom out, this shows the whole of the explorable galaxy in Elite Dangerous. Now, I am here. It took me all day yesterday. Like, it must have taken me at least 6 or 7 hours. In real time, this is, I'm talking real time, to travel from Dillon Hub, which is, I believe, here. I can't zoom in. The galaxy map's a bit annoying in VR, but you can see where this bookmark and this ship thing is. 51 Aretis. That's where I started, over at Dillon Hub there. So I have traveled all the way across here, and I'm currently here. My goodness, and it took me so long to get there. My destination, though, my final destination, is here. Colonia, all the way over here. This is 22,000 light years away from the bubble. 22,000 light years. That is a heck of a lot, 22,000. So, yeah, I wanted to document this. I wanted this to be online, I wanted it to be on stream, just so that you guys can join me on the journey, and so that I can look back on it. I mean, this really is, like, an immense journey. It really does put into perspective how big and amazing this game is. I've already discovered some new star systems that have never been discovered before. I haven't handed in the data yet, but that's what we're doing. And we're going to carry on this journey not for very long, for about an hour or so today, just so that you guys can see where I am. I've got some bookmarked places where I need to head to. Over here at the Lagoon sector, that is where I know that there is another station. So I want to head there, so just so that I can lay off some of my exploration data, because I really don't want to lose it, because this is going to be a dangerous mission. All kinds of things could happen. I could fly into a black hole. I could fly into a star. I could crash. I could run out of fuel. There's so many things that can go wrong. So any opportunity that there is to kind of save the game as such, it's not saving the game, but at least kind of hand in my exploration data, because that's why I'm doing this. I'm doing this mainly for the exploration. So I can do that here at Lagoon Sector. So that's that, yeah. So before we get started, I am just going to check the status of the stream, just to make sure that everything's okay and we're all good in the hood. I sincerely hope so. I've recently improved my internet connection, so hopefully what's happened in the past where my stream is cut out because it gets to like peak time, hopefully that won't happen again. So let me just check that the volume and everything's working.
Years away from the journey, so that I can look back on it and carry on this journey. Not for my whole
okay.
Could,
looks okay.
I could fly into a star, crash, I could break fuel, I could do so many things that can go wrong. So any opportunity.
I'm just making sure that the quality is good enough for you guys. I sincerely hope so. Any issues, by all means, say so in the comments. Even if there isn't any issues, please leave me some comments. I would really love to hear what you guys have to say. It means a hell of a lot to me. And like I say, one of the reasons I'm doing this is because I want you guys to kind of join me on this journey, this voyage of discovery into the darkness of the galaxy. So, we need to get this thing underway. We've wasted enough time already. So, we should have a course plotted. Maybe not. Oh, that's the system map. Don't want that. God, I'm not showing off my commander capabilities very well here, am I? Right, so our next bookmarked stop is Smooju GLP. So where is Smooju GLP on my bookmarks? There it is. Plot a route. So it's 384 light years. That's not really that far, to be fair. It's not too bad. Okay, so we can do that in 15 jumps. That's fine. Right, so let's throttle up and head on down. So yeah, I hope the definition is okay for you guys here. I hope it all looks good. If you are joining the stream, please be sure to say hi in the comments. And we're going to go underway. We're going to go into our first hyperspace. So I've got this ASP kind of kitted out for exploration. It's not as kitted out as it probably could be. I've still got cargo bays and stuff like that installed, but I didn't really need them. I've got an SRV as well. Don't really need that either, but you know, I've got them just in case. I don't know what we're going to find when we get to Jack Station. I'm not sure if they do have any missions at Jack Station which make us return to the bubble or anything. I don't really know what to expect, but in any case, it's going to be an interesting ride. So I need to make sure that I scan every system that I come in. And I'm only halfway. I've only got half a tank full of fuel. I've got a fuel scoop installed. I'm not sure what class of fuel scoop I've got. Let's just have a quick look. So I've got a 3A fuel scoop installed, which is pretty good. It's not the best fuel scoop that you can get, but it's still pretty good nonetheless. I does take a few minutes for this thing to fill up, but before I had like a 2C or something fuel scoop, and it took forever. It took absolutely ages for this thing to fill up on fuel. Right, we're starting to get a bit hot, so we'll carry on. We'll just check out the system map to see if there's anything interesting here while we cool down. There is a lot of planets here, but I'm trying not to scan everything. You know, I'm not really scanning much on our route to Colonia. There is one or two systems which were undiscovered, so I made a point of scanning those. In fact, one of them, I scanned everything within that system. It actually took me quite a while, but it was worth it, because for me, it would be great if one day somebody stumbles across that system, they look on the system map, and everything has been discovered by the Gaming Mule, or in this case, my username is the Moscow Mule. Sadly, not the Gaming Mule. If it did say the Gaming Mule, that would be even better, but I'm quite satisfied with just the Moscow Mule. So this is just going to be me traveling around the galaxy. I'm going to be doing it off stream as well as on stream, but anything that I think I might come across as interesting, I'll try and stream it. Something, if I'm expecting something to happen, I will stream it, although a lot of unpredictable things could happen on this journey. I would like to be able to get to this this other starport today for you, but I don't think that's going to happen today. But I wanted to give like an introduction, tell you guys what was happening, tell you guys what I was doing, and I want to be part of those select amount of people, the minority of the community that has traveled to Jack Station. And I'm hoping to make a fair bit of money from it, and I'm hoping to, you know, kind of up my exploration rank. My exploration rank is currently at 37% on Trailblazer, which is pretty cool, which is a pretty good amount. I think Pathfinder's the next one on the scale of things. So, yeah. As I say, if you are joining, then please be sure to check out the... be sure to say hi in the chat, leave me some comments, because... you know, I want you guys to be involved, and I want some company along the way, if I'm going to be perfectly frank. I'm going to be more vocal on Twitter about these things. I'm going to maybe schedule some of these things on Twitter so that people are aware of them, they know what's going to happen. And also be sure to check out my own channel as well as the Daydreamer Gaming channel. I stream fairly regularly. And on Daydreamer Gaming, we certainly stream every day, more or less. So, and we bring out other videos as well. We bring out guides. Currently, one of our guys, Viz, has got some guides going up for Hitman. And also, Lit has been doing some Persona videos on the hardest difficulty. And we've got the Games and Graps podcast, which was videos actually filmed last week instead of just recorded. And so, be sure, so much content on here. Please be sure to check it out. Please be sure to check out all of the Daydreamer's individual channels as well. I have a terrible fear of running out of fuel during this. It's something that genuinely worries me. And perhaps I'm filling up on fuel more than I should, or more than I need to anyway, but I don't like being too risky with these things. If you are watching this, then please be sure to let me know what the quality is. Make sure that everything's okay. It looked okay in my end, but if the resolution's not too great, or if the audio's a bit off or anything like that, please let me know. I'm terribly paranoid about something like that happening on here. Comments are open. If you see me looking up like this is me looking at the comments, because obviously I've got this big fucking thing over the front of my face. So, yeah! Really, really looking forward to this, but I'm kind of worried that towards the end of it, it's going to be just an exhausting, repetitive thing. I mean, like I say, I was doing this for like 8 hours or something yesterday, bank holiday Monday. I spent the whole day on the sofa with my girlfriend. We were watching telly all day, and I had my laptop on the coffee table, and I was just literally just playing Elite Dangerous for the whole time. Which was fine, which was great. I made a few credits, and that's when I decided to undertake this mission of mine. But now that the bank holiday's over, we're back to work, back to normality. This kind of thing is going to become a bit more difficult. But still, I want to do it. It'll be one of those things where it'll be hard on the way to get there, but overall, it's going to be great. Sunny G's online. How's it going, man? Thank you so much for joining. It says it looks and sounds great. Awesome. Thank you very much. If you've just joined, what I am currently undertaking is an enormous mission on Elite Dangerous. I am traveling to the center of the galaxy. Everybody starts off like on the same edge of the galaxy, something they call the bubble. But there's like a new station, there's a new area of the galaxy that's being colonized, and I want to go and see it, but it is going to be a huge undertaking. It's going to take me a long time, but I'm going to discover a lot of amazing things. Look at that star, it looks fantastic. Playing this in VR is amazing. Anybody that's watched any of my Elite Dangerous videos in the past will know how much I fucking love this game in virtual reality. I loved it even before I played it in virtual reality, but getting this Oculus and playing it now, it just adds so much. And being on this exploration mission, it's gonna just make things so much more enjoyable. And I'm hoping to come across some really interesting things. I'm hoping to come across some black holes, hopefully. One thing that I'm actually going to do, which is going to be like an extra once I've done this voyage, is I'm actually going to head directly to the center of the galaxy, to Sagittarius A, which is a black hole in the center of the galaxy, and apparently it's the most interesting part of the galaxy. You get bonuses for going there. I think you get an additional credits bonus for scanning Sagittarius A, so that's going to be great. I really look forward to that. Need to make sure I keep an eye on my fuel. As I said earlier, I'm not checking out. In fact, I'm going to slow down and we're going to fuel up a little bit, because we're less than 50%. I really am paranoid about running out of fuel on this journey, especially before I get to the first station on the way. I'm just checking out the stream health. Stream health is good. Yes, fantastic. First time I've had that when playing Elite Dangerous in VR. Having a good... even YouTube approves of this stream, which is nice. Right, we're starting to approach the 90% heat levels, which is where things start to get a bit hazy. I'm starting to wish that perhaps I should have gotten a better fuel scoop for this journey, but I so far it's been fine, so it's going to make the journey a bit longer, but ultimately that means I'm going to stop off at more systems, and that means I'm going to scan more systems, and then I'm going to end up with more money, more exploration data, which gives me a higher level in exploration, and it's all around good. Excuse me, need to scratch my nose. I don't know what it is about playing on a VR headset. It just makes my nose itch every time. And of course, as well, the closer that we get to the center of the galaxy, like the constellations are going to change and everything like that. The stars are going to become more dense as we go to towards the center of the galaxy. The environment is going to change. This isn't all just kind of random stars and everything like that. The guys at Frontier, the creators of Elite Dangerous, genuinely put an incredible amount of effort to make this game real, and the constellations that you see in with the stars are actually kind of based on real data. So, and there are areas of the galaxy that have been discovered by like the Hubble telescope and other astronomers which you can visit, such as is it the Pillars of Eternity or something like that, the Pillars of or the Pillars of Hades or something like that. I might be thinking of the game Pillars of Eternity when I say that. But and there's the Witch's Nebula and things like that. You can actually visit all of these places in the game. It all just depends on how far you can travel. Currently, with my my setup, my jump range... I should be able to see my jump range. Where do I see my jump range? My jump range is 29 light years, or 31 light years unladen. So I've got a pretty good jump range. It's not great. I mean, I am only in an Asp Explorer, and it's not fully kitted out. I don't have anything like an Anaconda or anything like that. And again, that's one of the reasons why I want to do this. Is, as I say, I want to make money. But I want to do it in an enjoyable way. And while this is going to take a long time, and for the amount of time it's going to take me, the credits yield probably isn't going to be the best. But it's all going to go towards getting an Anaconda or a Python. I think really the Python ship would be the next one to get after the Asp Explorer. And then I can work towards getting an Anaconda. An Anaconda, I believe, is around 100 and... I can't remember what it is. I'm thinking around 140 million credits. I know it's over 100 million credits anyway. So they are the biggest and best ship in the game. Currently I have, hold on, I'll have a look in a second. Currently I have 13.2 million credits. And that took me quite a while to get. And that was doing probably the best money-making missions that I can do at the stage that I am in the game, because with the latest Commander's update, I bought a Dolphin ship as well, which was so cheap, ridiculously cheap, the Dolphin, but it enables you to do luxury passenger missions, and you can get a good few million credits from some of those missions, from doing like taking on passengers and doing like tourist missions around the bubble area. And yeah, you can get a fair few million credits even just in the Dolphin, which is the smallest of the passenger liners. Obviously you've got the Orca and the Beluga as well, but they're out of my price range at the minute. I imagine that they're cheaper than the Anaconda. So perhaps the money that I get from this, wow, 47 objects in this system. Let's have a quick look at the system map for that. So yeah, maybe I'm aiming too high with the Anaconda at this point in the game. Perhaps I should be looking towards more an Orca or a Beluga. I can't remember which one's the largest of those two ships. I can't remember which is bigger, the Orca or the Beluga. So at this point, this is where I could be looking at these planets. This looks like... Oh no, it has been discovered, this system. But at this point, if I was doing some hardcore exploration, I could be checking out all of these planets and scanning them. Depending on what type of planets they are, it would yield more credits when I hand in the exploration data at the station that I'm heading towards. Why does it do that? And depending on what kind of planets they are, they can give you more credits. Like, I think water planets give you a lot of credits. Depending on the kind of stars that you have, they give you more credits. Why are we not going into... Oh. There we go. So... Yeah, there's a lot more to this that I could be doing, but it would take so long. I mean, as I say, I did find a system with a lot of bodies in it, which was completely undiscovered. No player had ever been to that area. So I went around checking everything out, and it took me a while. It probably took me about an hour to go to every planet, every moon, every star in the system, and check it out. But that's going to have my name attached to it forever. Or I sincerely hope it's going to be forever, unless Frontier reset the servers or some shit like that. Please, So a lot of these stars that we've come across so far have been quite similar, but there is actually a whole range of different stars that you can come across here in Elite Dangerous. You can find like blue-white stars, you've got white dwarfs, red dwarfs, brown dwarfs or brown stars. But we're going to be coming across all of these kinds of things within this time. On Mule's tour of the galaxy, you can see in the top corner as well that I have renamed my ship, because you've been able to rename ships now in the latest Commanders 2.3 update. So we are now, instead of in the Asp Explorer, we are in the Mueladong Explorer. Just because that was the first thing that came to my mind when... sorry, I got distracted by my phone vibrating there. I can't remember what I was saying. Yeah, the Mueladong Explorer, that was just the first thing that came to my mind. It's not the most creative of names, I have to admit, but fuck it! It's my ship, I'll call it whatever the hell I want, and it's the Mueladong Explorer! Ah, right, okay, so we're preparing to jump to the next system now, and onboard computer is telling us that this is a M-class red dwarf star. So this could be a little different to what we've seen so far. You've seen kind of the yellow, red stars. So a red dwarf could look a little different. I'm hoping. Not really, but still. It's not what I was hoping for. Right, we're going to do a bit of fuel scooping. So yeah, we can just kind of sit and stare at this. I might as well scan this star while we're here, actually. So I don't have to do this. Let's just check that, see if anybody else has discovered this before. I'm sure they have. Yeah, Dave X. Bastard! So Dave X has discovered this in the past. There we go. So that's that scanned. So we'll continue to the next destination. Brilliant. Okay. Fuel's looking okay, so we shall push on. So we'll just let the ship cool down a little bit. How many more jumps? Two jumps to the next bookmark. Fantastic. Right, so we've cooled down, so let's charge up. So, the next star is a Class G white yellow star. So, you get so many different kinds of stars. A lot of them do look similar, but some of them look very drastically different, and it's very interesting, some of them. And I'm hoping that we do come across something very interesting within our journey. So yeah, slightly different, not that different. So as you can see, every time I enter a system, I activate my discovery scanner, which you can see there on the left. And I've got an advanced discovery scanner, so that scans literally everything within a system. You do get basic discovery scanners, which only has like a certain range, and an intermediate one, which has a larger range, but the advanced discovery scanner has like an infinite range within a system, so it can scan literally everything. But if you want a detailed scan of a particular body, like a star, a planet, or a moon, then you need to kind of lock onto that planet and then get in close enough for your surface scanners to kick into effect. And that's how you get your name attached to different bodies as well. As long as nobody else has discovered them. So if you're just joining today, then welcome to Daydreamer Gaming. My name is Gaming Mule. Today, I am showcasing the first leg of my journey, or part of the first leg of my journey towards Jack Station in the Colonia system. playing Elite Dangerous, which is an excellent space flight sim. It is one of my favourite games on PC, not just in virtual reality, but just like in general on PC. Right, so it looks like, hold on a minute, I don't want to overheat. I still want to take in some fuel though. Right, we're just going to stare at this star for a second. Oh God, that's bright. We're going to scan it as well. And we've come to the bookmark which I set, so we need to head to the next one, which I'm hoping is going to be where the first station is on our journey. Lagoon Sector. So that might be too far away. I might need to set a bookmark in between over here, but let's find out. So I've already bookmarked Lagoon Sector. So it is, yeah, it is too far away from the onboard computer, the galaxy map, to plot a route. So we need to make another bookmark slightly closer to where that is. Could probably do one about halfway, or maybe even closer than that, to be fair. A bit closer than halfway, maybe a bit there. Right, let's just find any old star. You'll do. NGC 56530 Sector QJXB25. That is our next destination. Oh, Jesus. Right, how many... Oh, God, this is 37 jumps, so it is quite... Well, I don't think we're going to be able to make it to this station today, which is a real shame. But, like I say, this is like the introduction to this this leg of the journey. In the future, I might just stream when I just play the game, but I'm certainly going to want to stream when I come across or believe that I'm going to be coming across something of interest. So, yeah, 37 jumps or 32 jumps, 37 jumps, probably not going to be able to make by the end of this video. By the way, anybody that is watching, from 9 p.m. this evening, Greenwich Mean Time, so in about an hour and 20 minutes, an hour and 15 minutes or so, I'm going to be streaming on my own channel as well, the Gaming Mule channel. You'll find a link to that on the Daydreamer Gaming channel like homepage, where me and some of my fellow colleagues will be streaming Insurgency. There's going to be six of us playing. Insurgency is like a first-person shooter, like a tactical first-person shooter, and we're going to be having some fun with that. It's a great game. It is great for a laugh. I'm hoping that we're going to be playing some survival on that is hilarious. So if you are watching and you are looking for something else to watch this evening that's maybe a bit different to this, then be sure to check that out. If you're interested in seeing my future exploits and my mission to Jack Station in the Colonia system on Elite Dangerous, then please be sure to hit that subscribe button here on Daydreamer Gaming. And I also bring out Elite Dangerous videos, as well as many other videos on my own channel as well, so be sure to check that out. If you want any updates with regards to any of the channels, with regards to what I'm doing and what everybody else is doing on the Daydreamer channel, all the other Daydreamers, then please be sure to check us out on Twitter and Facebook as well. Links again to those will be on the homepage on the Daydreamer Gaming channel. Frameshift drive charging. So, hold on, I'll wait until we jump to the next thing until I say what I was going to say. So something that might be worth checking out as well is something that I actually only just noticed as we were plotting that route, is when we do get to the station here at Lagoon, our next stop could be one of these nebulas. You can see that there's a nebula there, the Trakea AA H2. Oh, there's another one here, the Omega Nebula. It could be worth checking some of these out along the way. I mean, we might as well make it as interesting as possible. There's the Trifid Nebula. I'm not sure which of these is. In fact, they may all exist. Every one of these nebulas, it's a possibility. There's a lot of them kicking about. I'm trying to see if there's any that look familiar from what I've read about nebulas in this, like the real nebulas. I'm particularly looking for like the pillars and things like that. But yeah, so that's where we're heading to, Colonia. After that, we're going to head to Sagittarius A as well. But, like, you know, baby steps, kids, baby steps. This is how far we've traveled so far. Now, that's not so far in this episode. I was playing this game all day yesterday. All fucking day. And that's how far I traveled. So this is going to take me a while. You know, with, like, 1 hour sessions, we'll be able to tell, actually, how far we've traveled in just, like, this 1 hour session. 1 hour-ish session that I'm planning to do. So that'll give you an idea of the scope of this this voyage, and what's going to be happening. And the closer that we get to the center of the galaxy, the harder it's going to be to plot our routes, because the stars and the systems become more denser as you reach towards the center of the universe, the galaxy, sorry. So that is going to be interesting. I mean, if we go into our camera view... Oh, what was that? I've just pressed the wrong button there. Just turned our ship lights on. That was stupid, wasn't it? I hope I've left them off. Hold on. Let's just double check. Let's just hop into the camera. That's me, by the way! I don't know why we put our ship lights on. But as you can see, the further away we get from the galaxy, the further away we get away from the bubble towards the center, you can see over there you've got like the blackness of space, the stars are more spaced apart. But then if we turn around towards our destination, you'll see that it becomes brighter with all the stars are more dense. That's where we're heading. That is where we are heading. Exciting, isn't it? Shame that we've not come across any like interesting looking stars yet. I was really hoping that we would come across something different so far in this stream. They're not uncommon to find stars that are different to kind of this, you know, your basic looking kind of orange star. Just fueling up again. So while we're here, we can have a look around. We can just have a quick look at the wonders of virtual reality. We're here in the Asp Explorer, the Muladong Explorer. And I love the canopy in the Asp Explorer, because it's got like this conservatory effect. So it's great for like exploration, because you can kind of look around and see everything. It's got quite a spacious cockpit. I mean, it's not huge, but it's not enclosed like some of the smaller ships. There's a hatch down there. That leads to our kind of second cockpit, where we can get a crew member if need be. I don't have any crew members because I don't. it's literally no point in having an NPC crew member in an Aspect Explorer, because you can't get fighter bays in this, where you can get small fighters that come out and help you out in a battle. You can get those with the larger ships, but not with the Aspect Explorer, because it just isn't big enough. So the only reason that additional cockpit is there for an additional crew member is for multi-crew. If you've got any friends that want to play this with you, and if you have turrets installed on your ship, then you can get a friend into your ship and they can control your turrets for you, which is fantastic. It's not something I've tried yet. It's kind of really the only aspect of the latest Commander's update that I haven't experienced. And it is quite a big part of that update, but sadly I've not tried it yet. But it is something I'm hoping to do in the future. I do know somebody out there that has an Anaconda, and he has turrets. So hopefully at some point I'll be able to check that out and kind of showcase that for you. Again, if there is anybody watching, please be sure to say hi in the comments, just so I know that you're there. I need some company on this journey. It's a long journey and I need company. So on average we're probably doing about 25 light years a jump here, so 22,000 light years, you know, an average of 25 jumps. Let's do the maths with that, shall we? Very quickly. So 22,000 divided by 25 is, so it's going to take me around 880 jumps in total to do this. And that's as long as we don't do any like hardcore detours. I don't expect to do any hardcore detours, but you know, if I want to go and check out one of these nebulas and things like that, then it's a distinct possibility that, you know, we could end up getting taking a detour on our way to Jack Station. But that's so that we can see some interesting things. Some interesting aspects of space exploration. So we're still 30 jumps away from the nearest bookmark. I don't think that's happening in this stream, motherfuckers. We've got a nice purple suit as well now. That was part of the update. It's going to disappear though now when we go into hyperspace. Ah! Bunny's disappeared! I need to have a look on the Frontier forums. I'm sure that somebody must have mentioned that, because that never used to happen. But since you've been able to change your avatar and personalize yourself, that always happens. And, you know, I'm not a huge stickler for immersion. You know, I'm not really somebody that's going to really have a moan about a break in immersion, unless it's something completely major. But I feel that is a slight break in immersion. But nothing that's going to stop me from enjoying the game. You know, I still love this goddamn game. It's just, you know, just something that I've noticed. Just a little bit of nitpickiness there. So we've only got a few more minutes left of this stream, guys, but thank you so much for joining. If you have watched this, if you're watching this retrospectively as well, then thank you so much for watching. If you've enjoyed this video, then please be sure to hit that like button. If you've got anything that you want to say about my journey to Jack Station or anything about Elite Dangerous, then please be sure to hit me some comments down below. If there's anywhere in particular that you think that I should visit, anywhere you would like me to visit, then leave me some comments. I might be able to pay them a visit. You know, keep a look on Twitter and I'll let you guys know when I'm likely to be streaming next, so that if there is something in particular you want to see that's within my kind of jump range at this point of the game, then I'll check it out. If you do want to check out those future streams or any of the other streams that we've got coming up on Daydreamer Gaming, then please be sure to hit that subscribe button, and also be sure to check out all the individual Daydreamers channels. Most of us do have our own individual channels as well, so we'd really appreciate it if you guys checked that out. You can also follow me directly on Twitter, not just the Daydreamer Gaming channel. You can check me out at Gaming Mule 88. on Twitter, and you can check me out on GamingMule88 on Facebook as well. So there's the plugs. We're going to carry on for a few minutes, and we're just going to enjoy this last few minutes without any more channel pushing or Twitter social media pushing. We can just absorb the vastness of this galaxy in Elite Dangerous and how No Man's Sky tried to achieve something like this and failed fucking miserably. Of course, if any of you are watching this and this is like the first time you've seen, you've experienced Elite Dangerous, you might think that this looks kind of boring what I'm doing, and I suppose it kind of is. This is something that not a lot of people do. I mean, there's many people that have done this, but the overall, I think the majority of the community in Elite Dangerous hasn't done what I'm doing, and you know, there is more to this game. What you would ordinarily do at the start of Elite Dangerous is you would be within the bubble, which is like the main area of the galaxy where most of the things are going on within the Elite Dangerous universe. And you will pick up missions, you know, you can trade, you can mine, take on passengers, you can do dogfighting, you can do exploration, maybe not to this extent. You can just do like basic exploration around the bubble. You can still do things like that. There's so many things that you can do, so many things to discover. There's plenty of stations for you to visit. There's you can do planetary exploration, where you can like land on a planet and you can get your SRV, which is like the surface, I think it's the surface reconnaissance vehicle, that's called. And you can go around and you can drive around the surface of planets and moons. There's an awful lot to do, so don't let, you know, if this is your first impression, don't let this discourage you from playing this game. You know, this isn't it. this is something different what I'm doing. And you've got no excuse not to buy this game now, even if you're a non-PC player, because the game is available on Xbox One, and it is very soon going to be available on PlayStation 4 as well, I believe. I'm not sure what it's like on a console. I can't imagine how the controls would work out and everything like that. I am using a controller to play this game, but I'm using a Steam controller. And this works perfectly, by the way, a Steam controller playing this game. I love using the Steam controller, but it has a number of different buttons. If you haven't seen the Steam controller before, I mean, it's got like two touch pads. It's only got one analog stick, but that's fine. It's got buttons, but it's got two pads on the back as well as the shoulder buttons. So, and you know, you utilize literally every single button on this controller for so many different things. So I'm not sure how that is going to translate to, or how it has translated to the Xbox One controller, or how it's going to translate to the DualShock 4. I'm not too sure, so I'd be interested to know if there's anybody that's watching that has played this game on Xbox. What do you think of it? Especially if you've played it on PC and then maybe moved on to the Xbox. I'd love to know what your comparison is. I mean, graphics-wise, I don't know if there would be much of a difference. Because I'm playing this in virtual reality, the graphics aren't as crisp as they would be if I was playing it just normally. But it's good, you know. The graphics are fantastic. I mean, I'm just going to refuel a little bit here. You know, the graphics are great. I mean, the textures are fantastic. And like I say, I haven't upscaled the graphics because it works differently with virtual reality. If I upscale the graphics, it doesn't look as clear to me in virtual reality. I actually have to downgrade the graphics a little bit. Because the text is really hard to read. You guys can probably read the text really well, like the Mulodon Explorer up there, and Mass Locks, Landing Gear, Cargo Scoop, all of that stuff. It's quite difficult to read it in virtual reality because obviously you're not, even though it has got a HD screen in it with a high resolution, when you've got it close up to your face like I have, it's distorted. It's going to be distorted, obviously. So it's not as crisp as it should be. Like, so you might be able to read some of these things here on my chair quite clearly. I can't really read them that well. I can make them out because I've played this game so much, but I've actually spent time staring at them. But I can see, you know, you've got like control and system and things like that there. Transmission, is that transmission? Transmission protocol? See, even though I'm really close to it, oh, went out of the track in there a little bit. It's very difficult to see it. Right, fuel's good. Let's just wait till we get back down to about 50% on the old temperature gauge, and then we'll crack on. How much have we travelled? We've travelled a fair bit, you know. I think certainly in the next episode, the next time I have a Bosch on this, I reckon I probably will make it to that first station, that first leg of this journey, which I'm thoroughly looking forward to. And I'm looking forward to unloading all of the exploration data that I've gathered so far. The guy that I know that I was talking about earlier that's got an Anaconda and I might try out his turrets in multi-crew, I sent him a message on Facebook earlier actually, because he posted a status about Elite Dangerous, something that he was doing. He was upgrading his Anaconda's weapon systems. And I said to him, you know, I mean, I'm assuming that a commander, an experienced commander such as yourself, has travelled to Jack Station, and I was just wondering how much money you made from the exploration data. And he said that he made about 11 million credits there and back, which I actually thought wasn't that much. I imagined it was going to be a lot more. A little while ago, I did do a bit of exploration. I didn't even come out this far. And I'm pretty sure that I got about 8 million credits. But I might be wrong in that sense. I probably am wrong. If he got 11 million credits going all the way to Jack Station, I'm not going to get 8 million credits from traveling just outside the bubble. That's ridiculous. But I don't know. I'm hoping that we get more. Because we're only traveling at 25 and 29 light years every jump, we're probably going to get more jumps than he would have done in his Anaconda or whatever it was that he travelled there in. Which, while it's going to take longer, it does equal more exploration data, more money, and more points into my exploration rank. Which is, as I said earlier, we're at 37% trailblazer on the exploration rank. So I don't know what it's going to get us up to after we've travelled to Jack Station, or after we've travelled to this first station on the way to Jack Station. I don't know what we're going to end up with, but I'm hoping. I'm not expecting to be elite by the time we get there and come back. But I would imagine it would be the next one down. I can't remember what the next one down is, but I would like to at least hope that we would be the next one down from Elite. It might even be Dangerous. No, I don't think it is Dangerous. But that's what I'm hoping. That's the plan. And then hopefully I'll be able to get a new ship. What I need to do is I need to find out how much the Beluga or the Orca is, because I think that's what I need to get. I mean, I really want to get an Anaconda, but it's going to take me a hell of a long time to get there, just in an Aspect Explorer or in my Dolphin doing poxy passenger missions. It's going to take ages to get like 100-odd million credits. So I think what I need to do is aim towards getting an Orca or a Beluga. Again, I can't remember which one's the bigger one. I can't remember how much they are. There are lots, but I don't think they're as lot as an Anaconda. And then I can take on like huge passenger missions, and hopefully it shouldn't take me quite as long. I really do just like looking into the vastness of the space. Sometimes when I'm just playing this game and not streaming and trying my best to be at least a little bit entertaining, I do just like looking up when I'm like in hyperspace. I just think it looks so good in VR. This game is amazing. Right, we're going to do a couple more jumps and then we're going to call it a day. I'll tell you what I might do when we re... If I'm really hoping that some of these stations have outfitting areas in them. I could really do with upgrading this fuel scoop. Maybe upgrading the fuel tank as well would be pretty useful. Again, I'm just scratching my nose, guys. I'm not picking it. Itchy nose with the old VR headset. Was that? Hold on a minute. I think we might have found something interesting here, guys. I think we've got two stars right next to each other. Hold on a minute. Let's just move away somewhat. Right, hold on, let's just scan this system a second. Right, I'm just going to slow down and we're going to have a look in the old camera. Oh, there we go. Look at that. That, people, is a photo opportunity. I don't know how we would get rid of the rings that are showing up like on our computer. Oh, there we go. Right, okay. So let's go into free mode. We might as well use this for a photo opportunity. I think it's important. Right, hold on a minute. VR photo opportunities are probably not great. Hold on. Right, that looks good. In fact, that looks bloody good. Right, hold on. Let's F10 this up. See, one other thing we'll do. Let's get a boost. Oh no, I can't get a boost on the go when I'm in Super Cruise, can I? So that still looks good though. Hold on, let's just see if there's any other positions we can get into that look good. There we go, I like that as well. Okay, great. Okay then, guys, well, I think we're just gonna leave that there. I think that is an excellent place to end it. Hold on a minute, before we do, let's just have a quick look at the system map. Let's just see what there is around here. Oh, there's three stars. Where's the other one? Hold on, there's three stars. Where on earth is the other one? Where is the other star in this system? It's probably behind one of those, actually. But either way, yes, as I said, that I think is a good place to leave that today, guys. You know what? I love that picture as well. Cool. Right. Yeah, thank you so much for watching, guys. That is the first leg of our journey towards Jack Station. If you've enjoyed this video, then please hit that like button. If you want to see any of my future videos where I showcase my epic journey towards Jack Station in the Colonia system, then please hit that subscribe button. And also, please be sure to check out my own channel at 9 o'clock this evening, Greenwich Mean Time. I shall be streaming a bit of Insurgency with a few fellow gamers. So be sure to subscribe to my channel and check that out as well. So I've been Gaming Mule, and I'll see you all again very, very soon. Bye-bye now.